What's up, guys? Eric Bray, Focus Fishing Guide Service, Table Rock Fishing Intel. Got another video fishing report for you for Table Rock. It is Tuesday, January 12th. Just got off the water. Fished for about 3.5-4 hours, I guess. A little bit tougher than I expected. Haven't really been on the water much the last 3 or 4 days. It's been cold and nasty and nobody wanting to go. And to be honest with you, I'm not that mad at them anymore that I'm gonna go out there when it's a high of 33 and blowing 15 miles an hour. Not unless I have to. But as far as our lake level is concerned, we are at 916.3, which puts us 1.3 feet above normal. Core's been running water, quite a bit of water actually. They've been running a minimum of 2 units 24/7. Every once in a while they're bumping it up to 3 or 4 units. So we do have a lot of water and a lot of current going through the lake right now. Water temperature, it has cooled off. Saw 46 this morning, 48.5 when I got off the water this afternoon. So it's definitely cooling down. We're not quite to shad kill range yet. We got to get down to the lower 40s, upper 30s before we start to see that. But the water has definitely cooled down. Bites changed a little bit. We'll get into that here a little bit. They are moving. I really think that the current and the fact that it's pulling these shad out of the creeks is making a big difference. I really struggled to get bit very well, very far back into the creeks, whereas we have been getting bit in the creeks pretty good. Seems like the majority of the shad have moved out to the main lake, and in turn the bass have pretty much followed them, so we're not really seeing a lot of stuff in the creeks. But best way to stay on top of that, of course, is to become a pro member of Table Rock Fishing Intel. Get you daily reports, weekly reports, feature videos, maps, everything to keep you up to date, help you find fish, help you catch fish on Table Rock. Check out TableRockFishingIntel.com, become a pro member, and get access to everything we've got to offer. But if you guys are going to come down, fish the lower end of the lake, deep bite is still really strong, catching a lot of fish deep on the lower end of the lake. Most of them, like I said before, they've kind of transitioned. They're moving out to the main lake. They're not really catching as many. We're not catching as many back in the creeks. Some of the bigger, deeper creeks, you will find some fish in towards the mouth. But really, most of the fish that are being caught fishing deep have been out in the main lake. Most of them are still pretty darn deep too. 55 to 65 feet deep seems to be where the fish are. Some around standing timber, some just on those long gravel runouts. It's really, the key is finding the shad. If you can find bait, you will find fish and you will get bit. The other bite that's working pretty good down there is a jerkbait bite. Again, most of those fish seem to be coming off of the main lake as well, mostly on main lake points, steeper stuff. Stuff that's got a good drop off near it. You got some deep water close by. You get a windy day. It was pretty breezy today. And actually, I'm in the mid lake and I caught a few on a jerk bait today as well. But really, you need this little bit of wind. Cloud cover would have helped, but it didn't seem to hurt it that bad. Wind, main lake points is really where most of these fish are coming from, just because the shad, for the most part, are out there on the main lake. Come up here in the mid lake area where I am today. I caught them both deep and on a jerk bait. Threw a rock crawler a little bit. Had one fish on, but I didn't get him in the boat. He came off. Most of the fish I caught today though were deep. Most of them on a Kytex swim bait or on a dual scuba spoon. And pretty much everything I caught deep today, the fish themselves were 55, 65. I think I caught one about 70 feet deep today, but most of them were 55, 65 foot deep, over as much as 120. And the only reason I was fishing out there was just because that's where I could find the better groups of shad, the better schools of shad, most of them on bluff ends. Didn't really see a whole lot on gravel down here. Most of the fish that I caught today were on bluff ends, at least the ones I caught deep were on bluff ends, steeper stuff, you know, out there where it rolls off. They were all pretty much relating to trees. They were a little bit stingy today. They didn't really want to eat real well. Had a lot of pull-offs, a lot of biting the tail off of the swim bait. But most of them, again, were in those trees on bluff ends, and you really had to work them hard. You get them to bite, I lost probably more than I caught today. I think I had 9 fish total with 6 keepers, and of those 9, 5 of them were deep, and most of them were either on, like I said, either the scuba spoon or on the swim bait, and I just kind of alternated those. I would find a group of fish, get them to react to one bait, and then once I'd catch one, they wouldn't hit that bait again. If I caught them on a swim bait, I'd switch to a scuba spoon and usually catch another fish. But it was not easy, and they weren't really in a feeding mood out deep. The other fish I caught today were on a spromic stick. Again, main lake stuff, 45 degree chunk rock points, ends of channel swings, ends of bluffs, washouts or landslides on bluffs. Only had 4, had a couple more pull off, but only had 4 on the stick bait today. And most of them, I mean, they're not hitting it hard. You jerk it and let it sit for about 5 or 10 seconds, and most of the time I go to jerk it again and there'd be one on there. They weren't really hitting it hard. So can catch them on a jerk bait. You can catch them deep up here as well. Not really throwing the mega bass yet. I generally don't throw the mega bass till the water gets a little bit colder. I like that slashing action that the McStick has when the water's in the mid to upper 40s. So that's why I'm throwing the McStick right now. Go up into the James. You know, a lot of fish being caught up the James on an A-rig all of a sudden. Talk to a couple of guys that fished, I guess it was Sunday, and they caught them on an A-rig pretty good. Not big fish, but they caught a lot of numbers, throwing an A-rig, mostly, again, main lake, because it really seems like these shad have been sucked out into the main lake and not getting as good of a bite. Not saying their fish aren't in there, but they're just not as active without having the shad present. So they're catching them on an A-rig, mostly around isolated timber, steeper main lake points. You can catch fish on a stick bait there as well. Same sort of deal. Spromic stick is, again, my favorite this time of year, but you can probably catch them on the mega bass as well. But you're really looking for that isolated timber on those steeper rocky banks, the ends of channel swings, you know, where they kind of swing and there's a creek at the end of it or a pocket at the end of it. That really seems to be key for catching those fish right now. Go up into the White River. The deep bite is still really good up the White River. Again, we're not catching them back in the creeks. You know, if you go back into a creek, you really, the shad just kind of disappear once you get not even halfway back. A quarter of the way back, the shad just kind of disappear. And I'm still saying that's because of the amount of current that they're running. We get this current shut off and then we'll work their way back into the creeks. But right now, most of the shad are out on the main lake, and that's where most of the fish are being caught. Jewel scuba spoon, some on the wrap of the jigging wrap, and on a swim bait, Kitek swim bait or Jack and Jaw swim bait, you know, working it out there deep, fishing most of the fish again. When I was up the White, late last week, they were 45 to 60. But, you know, I don't know. I haven't been up there since Friday, so I don't know if they moved out a little bit deeper like these fish here in the mid lake, but I'd start around 40 and start working your way out. The key is, again, finding the shad. If you can find the shad, you can find these fish out there deep. So keep your eyes open on your graph. Look for the big schools of shad, not just the little tiny puffs of shad, as we like to call the big good-sized schools of shad, at least the size of your boat or bigger. Jerkbait bites working up there as well. We did catch a few on a jerkbait when I was up there last Friday. Most of them, again, main lake or maybe the first third of the bigger creeks, steeper banks, rocky banks with isolated trees. You know, you go back, yeah, Big Creek's a great example. You go back in Big Creek, and there's a couple of banks right there in the mouth of that are perfect, except they have got a ton of trees. I mean, it's basically a forest out there, and it's hard to get bit when you've got a ton of trees. If you've got one or two trees scattered down that bank, you can get bit a lot better. If you got just go right across the lake from the one that's got all those trees on it, you've got one that's got about 4 trees and a 100-yard stretch, and I always get bit better where I've got those 4 trees versus having a whole forest of trees. And then the crankbait bite, when I was up there on Friday, we threw a rock crawler a little bit. Did manage to catch 2 or 3 on a rock crawler, and I think actually one on a wiggle wart. But most of those fish, you know, we had a little wind, had a little cloud cover, so those fish had moved up shallow. I think I probably could have caught some more on a rock crawler today if I'd had the cloud cover. I had the wind, just didn't have the cloud cover. But definitely have a rock crawler or a wiggle wart tied on if you're going to go up the White right now as well. Guys, we are, I guess about halfway through January. fishing, it's changing. It got a little tougher today, a little tougher than I expected it to be with this west wind, but I mean, we caught fish. I think by the end of the week, by Thursday, Friday, with this warming trend, definitely the bite will be better. It was 21 degrees this morning when I launched, so that didn't help matters any, but definitely a little bit warmer weather, a little bit more consistent temperatures. Having that southwest wind for the next 2 or 3 days is really going to help. Definitely want to have a stick bait tied on, jerk bait tied on. I think they'll still bite deep, and I think you can probably catch them on a wiggle wart or rock crawler as well by the end of the week. But best way to stay on top of that is to become a pro member of Table Rock Fishing Intel. Like I said, daily reports, weekly reports, maps, future videos, all that stuff is available when you become a pro member for just $45 a year. But check it out if you haven't done so already. TableRockFishingIntel.com. Take a look at what we got to offer. If you like it, great. Become a member and join up. But check out Table Rock Fishing Intel. I don't think you'll be disappointed. But if you're coming down, want to hire a guide, give me a call. It's Focus Fishing Guide Service. You can reach me at 417-860-4743 or hit my website, focusfishing.com, and either book online or shoot me an email. Either way, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Get hooked up. We'll get out here, see if we can't catch some fish. But guys, thanks for watching the videos. Again, check out Table Rock Fishing Intel. If you haven't already, thanks for watching. Can't wait to hear from you. We'll see you on the water.